game development is an environment where they already have an idea about how they approach these. And one of the first things you'll encounter if you talk to game developers is the concept of playtesting. Now, playtesting has been a traditional thing in the game industry forever. As long as they've been making games, developers have been putting their game in front of people and seeing what they think. And as a researcher, we might have some thoughts about how they're approaching this, but that idea, at least, of seeing what what players' experience of games is very familiar and very common as part of the game development process. Putting on our UX hat or a user research background, though, we can notice that their typical approach of let's put some people in front of this game, maybe we'll give them a survey, but we'll just see what they think about it, introduces a number of risks. Often these playtests are run with inappropriate players. They'll either get who's convenient, they might even be playing it themselves or asking someone else they work with to play it and see what they think. Playtesting often occurs quite late in the development process. As they're coming up to launch, they might then start exposing it to players, which again, we know as user researchers, it's often too late to make any changes at that point. The method selection might not be appropriate. They might just be running surveys because they're convenient or putting it in front of people and just asking them, what do you think at the end? And again, as user researchers, we know there are different ways of approaching that. And also because it's coming from a unprofessional, at least not a professional research background, some of the questions or the ways they approach answering those questions are going to be biased. They're going to ask people, do you like my game? Not recognizing that there might be nuance or better ways of answering those questions. That's where we step in. As games user researchers, we take a lot of the best practice from UX elsewhere and from the scientific methods to bring some structure to their playtesting process. Again, going through steps where we'll do some proper planning, working out what are the research objectives and what we need to learn from the study. We'll prepare an appropriate study design and some methods. We use rigorous methods of collecting that data and asking unbiased questions to make sure we're getting good quality data back from that. And we go through a formal analysis process. We look at all that raw data and we dive deep into it to work out what is the meaning, what does this data represent. Ultimately, the reason we do all of that is because it gives answers to the game teams. They had all those questions like, is our game fun? Do players understand how to get through the tutorial? Is this game too easy or too hard? And we can run our studies, come up with reliable answers, and then tell game developers or game designers or game producers the answers so that they can make confident decisions about what they need to change about their game or what they need to prioritize in their development process.